every year when I was growing up. My mum made a traditional Christmas pudding. Now I'm getting her back in the kitchen to help me cook my updated version. A modern, light steam pudding with whiskey cream. It's super simple to make and deliciously delicate to eat. And it can be flambéed at the table so you don't miss out on all that drama. All right, Mum. Welcome to a proper kitchen. Now, today we're not going to burn anything. We're going to make a really nice, fragrant, steamed, yeah, sponge pudding. Why are you looking at
that? Christmas sponge pudding. Why?
Well, we never get to eat Christmas pudding because we're always a little bit too full, so I want to make something a little bit lighter.
People like to stick to tradition in Christmas, can't they?
Would you mind if I just try something a little bit different?
Yeah, well, you go, let's have a go at it.
First, Mum grates the zest of an orange into a lightly buttered pudding basin, whilst I get on with a sponge mix. Add 210 grams of butter and 210 grams of light brown sugar to the mixer and beat.
Do you think your way is good way?
Trust me. Mum, I know it's my kitchen, but there's only one way, and that is my way.
Oh, don't be cheeky now. Is that enough, chef?
Did you just use all the orange? I don't like waste. So sorry. That was you who taught me that. Then pour a few tablespoons of maple syrup into the pudding basin and put in 3 bay leaves. Bay leaves are an extraordinary versatile herb.
Bay leaves in a pudding? I've never had that.
Really? Their bittersweet, spicy taste works brilliantly in everything from meat stews, marinades and fish dishes to sweet custards and rice puddings. To finish the sponge mix, beat together 4 eggs and slowly add to the cream butter and sugar.
Slower, slower.
And again, please, nice and slow. Slowly. There you go. Right, now, flour and baking powder. Sieve in 100 grams of self-raising flour and 3 teaspoons of baking powder. Then add a teaspoon of ground cloves. It gives that really nice sort of aniseedy richness to it.
There you are.
Okay, thank you.
Can you look at the measurement? So you kept that nice.
Right, a little pinch of salt. And I'm just going to give that a nice little mix. Fold that flour in.
Why don't you use a whisk when you're doing that?
Because I want to knock all that air out there. Now, into the bowl. Okay. Steaming the pudding in a sealed container means it cooks slowly and keeps in all the moisture, making the sponge lovely and light.
Lovely.
Nice. To cover the pudding with a circle of baking parchment, take a square sheet and fold.
Yeah, over halfway. See?
Yeah. That's going to fit lovely. And a little bit of butter. Butter one side so it doesn't stick when the pudding cooks.
Top that up.
And tie it tightly over the basin.
Can you put your finger on there for this one?
Lovely. Tin foil. Shiny side out. And twist. Yes. Once the pudding's sealed, place a ramekin in the pan. This keeps the basin off the bottom so it can steam evenly.
I should put a wee saucer in the bottom of it.
A little saucer? Really? Pour in hot water, pop in the pudding, and steam for 1.5 hours, topping it up with hot water if it boils dry.